This video will teach you how to buy wholesale clothing in the United States as opposed to importing from China. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel. That way, as I release more content like this, you will get notified. And if you are on YouTube, click on the alert notification button. Now, for most of you starting out, importing clothes from China is going to be overkill, and you need to know that you can move product in volume before looking overseas. Now, in this day and age, there's this misconception that very little manufacturing is done in the United States. After all, most of our computers, our electronics, our mobile phones, and our textiles are either manufactured in China or in a different third world country. In fact, when my wife and I first launched our online store, we actually went straight to China for our goods. But recent events have caused us to switch gears with our sourcing strategy, and we are now looking to buy wholesale clothing in the United States. Now, for one thing, prices in China have gone up significantly over the years and continues to go up at a rapid pace. More and more of the Chinese workforce no longer wants to work in the factories, and those that remain are receiving significant raises. Now, don't get me wrong, we still get most of our products from China, but there are some inherent disadvantages in doing so. For example, the lead times for receiving product are on the order of months. For example, we typically have to order our goods 3 to 4 months in advance, which makes inventory planning extremely important. The minimum order quantities are also significantly higher. Now, the prices in China are super low, but you have to commit to larger quantities in order to make it worth your while. And then finally, communication can be a problem. In order to communicate with our factories, we either have to stay up late or wake up super early, and designing new products in China can be somewhat problematic as well. But when you source product in the United States, everything is a whole lot easier. Your vendor is just a phone call away, the time zones are manageable, and in the worst case, it's actually really easy to hop on a plane and visit your supplier directly. In addition, more and more of our customers have been looking to buy goods made in the good old USA, so we've decided to make an effort to source product locally as opposed to overseas. Now, a while back, I had my buddy Emmanuel Alaye on my podcast, and he inspired me to take a trip to the LA Fashion Garment District to look for suppliers. And for all of you who don't know who Emmanuel is, he is the founder of SatinLineCaps.com, and he produces all of his products locally. You can actually catch his podcast episode in the show notes below. Anyway, Emmanuel sources all of his fabrics and his labor from Los Angeles, and his cost of goods are actually quite reasonable. Plus, it's refreshing to hear that you can easily find contract seamstresses and designers willing to work for a very small shop. So a while back, my family and I took a trip down south to the LA Fashion District in search of new suppliers for our products. Now, the LA Fashion District is located in downtown Los Angeles and is known for being a creative center for the fashion industry. It is a top destination for wholesale buyers, retail shoppers, clothing designers, fashion students, and Hollywood stylists. And what is nice is that everything is all densely packed and completely walkable. Like, the whole area is about 10 blocks square, I would say. And while my wife and I didn't cover the entire thing, we did manage to visit a decent portion of the fabrics and textiles section. Now, what's funny is that as soon as my wife and I arrived at Santee Alley, one of the main streets of the district, I immediately felt like I was in China. Now, with the exception that very few Chinese people were in sight. There were stables and stables of clothing shops and accessory stands all over the place. Merchandise was everywhere, and it was quite overwhelming. Now, if you've ever been to the ladies market in Hong Kong, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. Anyway, so we get there and we start aimlessly looking for shops that sell products similar to what we want to stock in our shop. And it's crazy how much variety that you can find over here. In fact, there was so much to see and visit that I decided to contact Emmanuel for some advice. After all, I figured that there must be some method to the madness. So here's what I wrote to Emmanuel. Hey Emmanuel, this place is pretty overwhelming. What is a good place to start? We brought along samples of our products to be created, and any advice would be awesome. And here's how Emmanuel replied. Samples are a great idea, significantly speeds up the conversation, but I prefer to think about the LA Fashion District as a treasure hunt. There really isn't a destination you're going to or a starting point, more like steps in a discovery process to your destination. I would try and find something as close to what you're looking for to start. This can even be done online before getting there. And then when they tell you that they don't have it, ask who does. And after 4 or 5, you'll finally start to get closer. And after 4 or 5 more, you might actually find it. Or you might get lucky and find what you're looking for right away. The most important part is to prepare mentally to be walking around all day and stopping into 10 to 15 plus shops, and also never forgetting to ask who else might have this. Even other store visitors and not just the owners of the shops. Respectfully, Emmanuel. Now, I guess I was totally wrong because there really is no method to the madness at all. And I was thinking to myself, if this was easy, then everyone would be doing it. So we took Emmanuel's advice to heart, started walking door to door and asked questions to vendors that sold items similar to what we wanted to sell. And I remember ending up at this one gigantic fabric warehouse and learning a ton of info about the different types of fabrics and their uses. And what's funny here is that we've never had to deal with any of this stuff importing from China. For our Chinese vendors, we simply attended the Canton Fair, picked what we wanted from their samples, and off we went. But here in the garment district, you kind of have to know what you want, and then you can start asking more intelligent questions. Now, thankfully, my wife brought actual samples of product from our shop to show everyone so that we had something physical to refer to, but our entire journey was 100% random. And to give you an idea of the randomness, we visited this one shop run by a nice Chinese lady that sold dresses and women's clothing. And the reason we stopped at her shop was because her business card indicated that she was a manufacturer of clothing. Anyway, after chatting with her for a couple of minutes, we discovered that she didn't have what we wanted and that she only manufactured her own designs. But when we showed her some of our sample aprons that we brought, she offered to help us make them. Next thing you know, we start chatting about prices and the manufacturing process, and then she refers us to some other people within the fashion district to talk to. In fact, our entire journey in the LA fashion district was just one referral to the next. In any case, if you ever decide to go, be prepared to do a lot of walking and being pointed in different directions. Now, the upshot of our aimless wandering was that we learned a lot about the manufacturing process and all the pieces involved. And to summarize, we learned that the prices to have our goods made in the US were roughly 2 to 3x what it costs to make the same item in China. And this is just the labor, actually. But the minimum order quantities were significantly lower. All you had to purchase were a handful of units. You can also have a prototype made on the spot if you have a design pattern and fabric in hand. Now, there are many different steps and players involved in making a single piece of clothing. There's cutters, there's sewers, and a whole bunch of other people in the process. But the LA Fashion District is actually a great place to find wholesale clothing vendors. And overall, if you want to have something made in the LA Fashion District, it actually helps to have a prototype in hand to show to the vendors. That way, you can get an accurate quote for how much it costs to make. And when it comes to fabrics, it can be terribly overwhelming unless you know what type of fabric you need. And in fact, you should probably spend some time doing the research before you go to the LA Fashion District so you don't end up going crazy. But to sum it up, the experience was exactly how Emmanuel described it. You simply have to do the legwork and be inquisitive to get what you want. After all, there are a lot of people out there hungry for your business, and you simply have to reach out and ask. And for textiles, at least, it's worth looking to source locally at first before making a larger commitment to overseas manufacturing.
Hope you enjoyed this video. Now, if you like what you saw, there's actually a lot more where that came from if you subscribe to my channel below. And if you are interested in learning how to sell physical products online, then click over here and take my free 6-day mini course where I'll walk you through everything that you need to know to get started in e-commerce. Thanks for watching.